You're an expert on forest walking, right?
Well, yeah, sure, around here I am, around Oslo, but then we have so much forest. It's like maybe when you step outside of Paris, you'll find more Paris. If you step outside Oslo, you just find forest.
That's great.
So for anybody who wants to do forest walking around Oslo, what would you recommend?
It's a couple of days.
I would recommend first get a map, but before that even, it's a known fact that the first 5 meters are the most difficult. And the first 5 meters is getting your ass off of a fucking sofa, putting your boots on and walking out the door. When that is done and you're heading for the forest, and around Oslo, is the forest is usually pretty close, then you've done at least half the job. At least. One of our movie stars in Norway is a movie star because he was only in movies about wildlife. He's very well respected and he does seminars now and forest things for a living. And what he said was that when he was young, he just walked out into the forest. He didn't need anything. The first thing I'm saying is you don't really need anything. Just instead of looking at your floor or the TV or the IKEA stuff, try just to walk a little bit in the forest and let your eye watch the nature, because we come from nature. And what will happen with the brain is the eyes recognizes something that we had way back when. Lots of random trees and grounds, and the eye will give the signal to the brain that, whoa man, I know this. And the brain will be very, very pleased.
So
everyone that's been in the forest feel very pleased afterwards. And maybe some of them don't know why. I just told you why. The brain likes what the eye sees. Not, they don't see IKEA. They don't see a rock club. They just see lots of knots and trees and shit. And the brain of the humans are from that era where we did see that every day. Now we've been trying to escape from that all the time. So I suggest that you do both. Lead a happy life here in a rock club or in your apartment or whatever, and be out in the wild.
So
it's a good balance.
So why buying a map? Could you just walk into the forest?
Because buying a map is motivation. So you just don't wind up in the same area again and again and again. Maybe getting a map will tell you that there are some places worth to visit that you didn't know before. Maybe you go there. I sure as hell did. And I never looked back since.
So what should you actually take into mind when you're out there in the forest?
Well, first of all, there's no dangers. The dangers might be that you're a complete idiot and you're not really having in mind that you came from somewhere. You just can't really just walk and walk. Although, that doesn't matter either, because at least in Europe, most places you can walk, you can basically just walk and walk. you won't die. If you get lost, you just take to the nearest little running water, even if it's only a little, and you just follow it down to maybe a water, and then you just find where that water runs down to, and then you'll get back to civilization eventually. So there's no real problem, although if you get lost, you feel lost. But did that ever hurt anyone? I don't think so. I got lost, maybe out of 600 trips I did, I got lost on two or three of them. It wasn't pleasant, because I was one of the guys that actually had a map, and I got lost with the map. Didn't feel cool, but when I found shit, when I found back again, well, what can I say? It sometimes is good to know that nature is the real boss.
Do you need something like walking sticks, backpacks, special shoes, rope, stuff?
Oh, the backpack. As you Germans say, the backpack is very good and water is very good. Now, most people just go for a short walk and they don't really need any food. The food that's best for if you get lost and shit is raisins and oranges. It's very good. But usually you don't get lost. But water, of course.
Sticks?
Like this?
Yes, you also need things on your hands that you can use to look like the guy in Futurama. Very nice. Well, you don't need to have gloves. That's not always so good. It's best to have like all your fingers are together and your thumb apart. Not always gloves. Gloves is for city people.
Okay. Anything else that is important when walking in the forest?
Oh, these are some basic questions, you know. It's almost unbelievable. It's been so far since I was in the beginning stages. But if you really want to check out the scenery and walk in the forest, you really need to have some kind of shoes that are maybe not, you know, Ramon's shoes, like, you know, sandals are very bad. Maybe some kind of sandals that has full cover, meaning they are not sandals anymore, they're real shoes.